Most of us take electricity for granted and consider it a basic necessity. But did you know that besides the challenge of balancing power generation and consumption in the power grid, cybersecurity is becoming critical as well? In this video, we will define cybersecurity. Furthermore, we will explain why cybersecurity for power grids is becoming important. So what is cybersecurity? According to Cisco, cybersecurity is the practice of protecting IT systems, networks, and software against digital attacks. These attacks aim to access, modify, or destroy sensitive information, blackmail users to interrupt the normal operation of the IT system. Cybersecurity aims to preserve mainly three key attributes for data and IT systems. They form the cornerstone of any organization's security infrastructure. In fact, these key attributes should function as goals and objectives for every cybersecurity program. The first attribute is confidentiality. This means that the information on our IT systems and the data communicated through the IT networks are not accessed by third parties. Confidentiality measures are designed to prevent sensitive information from unauthorized access attempts. It is common for data to be categorized according to the amount and type of damage that could be done if it fell into the wrong hands. More or less, stringent measures can then be implemented according to these categories. The second attribute is integrity. This means that the data is not manipulated or altered by third parties. Integrity involves maintaining the consistency, accuracy, and trustworthiness of data over its entire life cycle. Data must not be changed in transit, and steps must be taken to ensure data cannot be altered by unauthorized people. Finally, we have availability. Availability indicates that information is consistently and readily accessible at all times for authorized parties. This involves properly maintaining hardware and the technical infrastructure and systems that hold and display the information. So there is no denial of service or other disruptions which result in the IT system being shut down. Now that we have seen what cybersecurity and the CIA triad are, let's discuss cybersecurity for power grids. On this slide, we have a typical representation of the power grid. On top, the transmission system interconnects the generation facilities such as wind farms, solar parks, battery storage, and conventional power plants. Control centers provide centralized monitoring and control capabilities to transmission and distribution system operators. On the lower level, there is the distribution system, which powers up our smart cities. Here we deploy EV charging infrastructure, electric transportation, micro generation, smart homes and smart buildings, heat pumps, and smart metering. The Internet of Things connects all these smart devices using machine-to-machine communications over 5G. Digitalization is one of the key drivers for the energy transition. Layers of information and communication technologies are rapidly deployed at all levels on the top of the power infrastructure. They are used to operate the power grid in a flexible, intelligent way. However, the information and communication technologies introduce vulnerabilities and cyber threats. Furthermore, with the rapid pace of grid digitalization, it is increasingly more difficult to keep the private communication networks of utilities separate from the public communication networks. Because of this, the attack surface of the smart grid is significantly growing. Therefore, the power grid is becoming more and more susceptible to cyber attacks. But does this pose an immediate danger? The answer is yes, and we will show you a couple of examples. One of the earliest cyber attacks on the power grid was the Aurora generator test in 2007. This was actually an experiment carried out by the Idaho National Laboratory for the US Department of Energy. In this attack, they targeted the control system of a 2-megawatt diesel generator. As a result, the generator started shaking and smoking, which caused physical damage. In 2010, it was reported that the Stuxnet malware targeted a nuclear facility in Iran. The aim was to take control and damage the industrial control system of the facility to impede the nuclear enrichment process. This was the first and most sophisticated malware to date that was used in a cyber attack to target industrial control systems. It is also possible to target the whole grid infrastructure rather than only individual components. If hackers can intrude the control centers for power grid monitoring and control, they can maliciously disconnect transmission lines, generators, substations, and other power system components. This will lead to cascading failures in the grid, resulting in a power system blackout. This is catastrophic as most of our daily activities are depending on electricity. We even have proof that such cyber attacks on the power grid are already happening. In 2015 and 2016, two cyber attacks were conducted on the power grid in Ukraine. The hackers targeted the distribution system by taking unauthorized control of their industrial control systems. The cyber attacks resulted in power outages affecting hundreds of thousands of customers. The question then is, if such small-scale cyber attacks are already successful, how long it will take until the unthinkable will happen, a complete blackout in Europe. To recap, in this video, we have defined cybersecurity and look at the three critical security attributes for IT systems and data: confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Furthermore, we are rapidly deploying IT and operational technologies for power grids. They allow us for better monitoring and control, but it also makes the grid more susceptible to cyber attacks. We already have proof of various cyber attacks on industrial control systems around the world that resulted in equipment damage and power outages. However, we are not sitting still, but we are already analyzing these events to prepare for the future. And after following this module, you'll be prepared as well.